So you want to start a YouTube channel? Well, guess what? You've come to the right place. For the next 3 weeks, I'm going to be doing a series about how to start and grow your own YouTube channel. If you see me for the first time, hey, hi, what's up? My name is Rufaro. Welcome to the channel. If you like what you see, do subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on anything new. If you're returning savvy, hey, what's up? Shout out to you. I hope you had a great week. If you've been thinking about starting a YouTube channel and you need someone to literally push you over the cliff and hope to God that you can fly, then definitely I'm your girl, I'm your guy. This is what we're gonna be doing. So if you're interested, then definitely you need to keep on watching. I just want somebody to talk to. Someone that's on my mind. I want something that's all cool. If you're thinking about starting a YouTube channel, then definitely you've come to the right place. I'm just going to list down a few things that probably you've been thinking about over and over again and telling yourself that these are really good reasons why you should not start a YouTube channel right now. I'm not pretty. I'm not confident. I don't think I have what it takes. I don't even have a good camera. Damn, I don't even have a phone. I'm boring. No one is going to watch my YouTube channel. No one's gonna watch my videos. Imagine editing a video for 10 hours and only getting 54 views like this one right here. Oh well, it's too late. This platform is already saturated. There are like so many YouTube channels out there, so many YouTubers out there. I don't think there's space for me. I don't think there's room for me right now. And if you're African like me, definitely you've thought about, so what are people gonna say? Really? What? She's doing YouTube channels? Well, let me tell you right now, you're probably right. You're not confident. You don't have a camera. There are a lot of YouTubers out there, and yes, people are definitely going to talk about you. But what matters is, do you want this? Is your hunger for success greater than your fear of failure? Ask yourself these questions. If the answer is yes, then none of that matters. If your hunger for success is greater than your fear of failure, then none of that matters. You will find a way of making it work. I believe that my worst video is this one. Click on it. Watch it. Most of my first videos were really not that great. Like, the lighting was bad, the sound was poor, the topics were off. I really wasn't being myself because I was trying to think, okay, so what do people want to watch? And I was creating content that I believe people wanted to watch. And some of that content was not really a true reflection of what I'm all about. And that shows when you're making your YouTube videos, when you're not being yourself. When it comes to pursuing your goals, the important thing is to start. Just start with what you have. I mean, you have to start from somewhere. Do not compare yourself to other people, to other YouTubers that you believe, okay, I think they're doing better than I am. There are people that started their YouTube channels around the same time as me, and they've already hit 1,000 subscribers. And then there are those that started their YouTube channels around the same time as me, and they've barely gotten to even half of the number of subscribers that I have. But we're on different journeys. So focus on yourself and what you have. Focus on yourself and what you are trying to achieve. Like right now, you don't even need a laptop for you to be editing videos. There are lots of mobile apps out there that can help you to do that. So if you don't have a camera, borrow a friend's camera or borrow a phone from your friend. If you don't have a nice background, I mean, look at my background. You don't see any nice faces there. You don't see any fairy lights there. It's not because that I don't want those things to, but right now I'm working with what I have. You know, if you don't have a place to, you know, like shoot your videos, you can go and do it at your friend's house. How badly do you want this? If you know you want this to work, I believe that you'll find a way of making it work. Starting a YouTube channel is for free. You don't even need to pay a dime. You're learning new skills like video editing, like social media management, like online reputation management. You're learning how to do graphics, how to do research. You're understanding what is happening around you, particularly in the digital world. You're also gaining new speaking skills, like all you do is talk. I mean, look at me, my confidence levels have definitely improved. If you watch my first video right here, you'll see that I could barely look at the camera. I was shy and I was literally blushing, and you could tell that I was really having a hard time. But I'm improving, and that's all that really happens when you're doing your YouTube videos. You can only get better, you can't get worse, because all you're doing is reflecting on the stuff that you've done before and seeing, okay, so what works? How can I improve? What else is out there? How can I make my content more engaging and actually improve on the overall quality? So you can only get better as you make more videos. YouTube is amazing because I've managed to actually promote my online shop right here. I'm getting sales. I did a video where I was showcasing some of the products that I sell in my online store, and I'm still getting inquiries up today. Some of those inquiries are actually transferring like to traffic and sales on my online store. So this is an opportunity for you to showcase whatever it is that you're doing. If you bake, you can do your baking videos here. There are lots of people that love to watch that. If you're an influencer and you know you're into doing beauty stuff or clothing, you can do clothing hauls. You can try on beauty makeup challenges and all those stuff that happens here on YouTube. There's a lot that happens here. If you're still watching, you're awesome. That means I'm making sense. I'm talking sense right now. Please subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on anything new. I love YouTube because you're able to build your brand, and I believe that that can actually work the same for you. And once you get monetized, you get a regular income, which is the goal, the ultimate goal really for most YouTubers is to get monetized. And with YouTube on this particular platform, what you put in is what you get out. So you need to be consistent in terms of the effort and the content, the quality of content that you're bringing to the table, and making sure that you're trying to engage with the right audience. One thing that I can tell you is that African YouTubers based in Africa need to work twice as hard to get half as much as other YouTubers out there. And that's because the ad rates for the audience in Africa is lower than it is compared to America or Britain or Australia or any other first world country for that matter. Even the rate of subscriber growth is lower for most African YouTubers than it is for other YouTubers out there. For example, in America's got the largest audience of YouTubers out there. So definitely in terms of producing content, it's easier for YouTubers out there to go viral or to produce, you know, or to start a channel today, and within a week they already have 1,000 subscribers. But for the audience in Africa, where technology is something that is still being rolled out in terms of social media, the adaptation is not as fast as it is in other countries. You'll find that the people around you may actually not even be on YouTube. So growing your YouTube channel also takes time. So in the end, you'll get more money if most of your audience, even though you're based in Africa, if most of your audience is based in America or Australia or any of those first world countries, you will get more. So for me, I do not see this as a block, as a stumbling block to the things that I want to achieve on this particular channel. I see an opportunity. There's opportunity for growth. It means that if you can see the rates right now, if you can see the trends or the statistics, they're telling you that the African market is growing, the African audience is growing on YouTube, and I want to be there when the African audience starts to rise and continue to rise higher and higher and higher. When I first started, I thought that, oh, I want to be like the first, you know, Zimbabwean YouTuber to do this. I'm going to be in the top 100 Zimbabwean YouTubers to do this. And then I come on this platform and I was shocked, like, there are thousands, guys. There are thousands of Zimbabwean YouTubers out there. And their content is amazing. And they're just not known, but definitely there's a lot going on here. And it's nice to actually connect with people from your own country, from your own tribe or village or school or whatever. So there's an opportunity in Africa for you to be able to grow, despite the fact that right now the audience may not be as strong as in other countries. So don't be discouraged if you're thinking there's too many YouTubers out there. I don't think I can survive or thrive in that particular environment. Yes, there are a lot of YouTubers out there, but guess what? The right audience will find you. There's a lot of room on this platform for everybody because we're all unique and we've got something different to bring to the table. And people like variety, people like options. All you have to do to make sure that your audience find you is to make sure that you produce quality content. Be authentic as you're producing your content. Make it engaging. Post consistently so that people keep coming back for more, and share your content with the right audience. I'm still learning. My channel is slowly growing, but I'm very happy because when I look back to where I started about 4 months ago, I think, and where I am right now, I've grown so much and I've learned so much. My confidence has improved, my speaking skills have improved, my video editing skills have improved, and I can use these skills anywhere, not necessarily being here on YouTube. So if you're thinking about starting a YouTube channel in 2020, all I can say is just do it. Like, literally just do it. I don't mean to shout at you, but for it to really sink in, I'm feeling like I need to put on my serious face here. Just do it. You will succeed, you will grow, and do not be hard on yourself. I remember I had a video that I posted, I think it was on Sopa or something like that, and it got like 20 views, and it stayed on 20 views for almost 4 weeks. But right now, those views have gone like, almost 60 times from that particular point in time. So yes, right now when I post content on this platform, I'm looking at it as an investment. Someone might not watch that video right now today, but a month from now, 2 months from now, 3 months from now, that content may become relevant to someone out there, and it will start to grow and start adding value. So don't be hard on yourself. So yeah, guys, that's it from me. If you're thinking about starting a YouTube channel in 2020, there's never been a right time. Like, I just started. It was at the beginning of the pandemic, and the lockdown in South Africa just hit, and I was thinking, okay, so now I've got more time on my hands. What am I going to be doing for the next couple of weeks? And then it turned into months. So I started YouTubing, and I haven't looked back since. The journey has been hard. It is very difficult, but it's because I'm hungry and I want this. And my hunger for success is greater than my fear of failure. So I am going to push, and I'm going to keep doing this until I get monetized. I hope you enjoyed the video. Do share the video with anyone that you believe might find value in this. If this video was for you, awesome stuff. I hope that you liked it. Do subscribe, hit the notification bell, because you know what? It helps the channel to grow. It helps me to see that, okay, I think I'm making sense out there. So that's it for me, guys. Have a good one.
Nobody stealing covers. I like to.